I'm in Dubna in Russia, the birthplace of six super heavy elements. We're on the Nabezhnaya Mendeleeva, the Mendeleev embankment. And here I am next to the statue of Dmitri Mendeleev. And what I want to tell you about is the things that I've learned in the last few days about the chances of making the super heavy elements 119, 120. So these are really special because they will begin the eighth period, the eighth row of Mendeleev's table. Before I came here 2 days ago, I thought that there was real questions whether or not it was possible ever to make these elements. I now realize it's much more a technical problem. People can see how this should be done, but they can't quite work out which is the best way. So let me try and explain to you the problem. The real success in the last few years in making elements 113 to 118 has been in the projectile, the light atom, that has been accelerated towards the target. And this has been the very rare isotope of calcium, calcium 48, that has a big excess of neutrons. The problem is that we have now got to the stage where we have run out of suitable target materials. To make element 119, you need to have element 99, that's einsteinium, as the target, because calcium 20 plus 99 makes 119. The problem is that einsteinium is a very difficult element to make. If the Oak Ridge National Laboratory runs a dedicated campaign to making it, they could make 40 micrograms, which would cost somewhere between $5 and $10 million. And that would be enough to make a target that was only 1.5 square centimeters in area, much smaller than the current targets that are used for these experiments. So a whole new technology will have to be developed to stop the target overheating. The other approach is to use a different projectile. There are ideas of using either 51 titanium or 54 chromium and the existing targets. The problem is that with titanium and chromium, the chances of the successful collision taking place are much less than with calcium. So you need a much more intense beam. So there's the technical problems, choosing your projectile, choosing your target. But assuming you've done that, where on earth can you do the experiment? And this is why it's been so exciting being here in Dubna, because they're building a special new facility with a more intense beam so that these experiments can be done. And it has a terrific name, the Super Heavy Element Factory. The building is built, or almost built, and the accelerator is just being assembled. Brady and I were really lucky. Yuri Aganesyan, the person after whom element 118 was named, Oganesson, took us for a private tour round the new facility, which is still being built. So at the center is a huge magnet that is going to be used for the cyclotron, for the accelerator. Ions are accelerated, whichever projectile they choose, goes into the space between the poles of the magnet and is accelerated round and round in a spiral path from the center to the outside. And by the time it gets to the outside, it will be traveling at about a tenth of the speed of light. And at the moment, they've just got the magnet in place. It weighs 1,100 tons. And at the moment, they are measuring the magnetic field to make sure that the magnet is performing perfectly before they put the actual accelerator inside. But the accelerator should be up and running by the end of this year, 2017. So once the ions come out of the accelerator at this huge speed, they go into a separator, which is rather like the switching system at a railway junction, which can send the beam down one of 5 different beam lines to 5 different experiments. And that in itself is quite a huge piece of equipment. But most exciting of all, Brady and I were taken into the rooms where the targets are going to be. We were the first visitors in this huge empty room. And it was really quite moving to think this is where element 119 and 120 may be born. I was particularly fascinated. They've already drilled the holes in the walls where the beam is going to come through. So you can look through this hole and see the atom's eye view of the accelerator, that what the target will see as the beams are coming towards it.
I think this is fantastic. It's a completely empty room, but this is the room where the new elements, 119, 120, are likely to be made.
So 5 years ago, we made a video about preliminary experiments trying to make element 120 from titanium and californium, titanium projectile californium target, not here in Dubna, but in Germany. The results were actually slightly more promising than I realized when I made that video. This is not the sort of experiment that will necessarily give you a new iPhone tomorrow, but on the other hand, it will give us a lot of scientific understanding. But the really important message that I and Brady have got from this visit is that things are really quite well on track to make elements 119 and 120. Whether it'll be in 2 years or 5 years or 10 years, nobody can tell, but certainly the science is there and we know where we're going and it looks really promising. Scale. There are 2 grams of calcium carbonate here, which are worth, or at least if you wanted to buy it, would cost you about $500,000. So my hands are getting quite cold.